Now consider this question, and it is a very interesting question as we have covered the topic that in pipelining we use some kind of stages, and after every stage we have some kind of buffer. So this question is actually based on that. Just look at this question, first of all read this question, then we'll try to do the question one by one. So here it is saying a 4-stage pipeline has the stage delay of 150, 120, 160 and 140 nanoseconds respectively. The registers that are used between the stages have a delay of 5 nanoseconds each, and assuming the constant clocking rate, the time taken to process 1000 data items on this pipeline will be out of these options, which is the correct option. Okay, so let us read out this question one by one and let us try to do it again. Okay, so it is saying that we have 4-stage pipelining. So assuming that these are those 4 stages, this is the first stage, which is the stage S1, then this is the second stage, which is the stage S2, and we have the third stage, which is the stage S3, and then we have the fourth stage, which is the stage S4, and they are giving a delay for each of these stages. The first stage is having a delay of 150 nanoseconds. The second stage is having a delay of 120 nanoseconds. The third stage is having a delay of 160 nanoseconds. And the fourth stage is having a delay of 140 nanoseconds, right? And between these stages, they are saying between these stages, they are using some kind of buffer, and that buffer is having a delay of 50 nanoseconds each. So here you can see this is a buffer. It is not 50, it is 5 nanoseconds. So it is 5 nanosecond of delay. Again, there's a buffer here, which is having 5 nanoseconds of delay. There's a buffer, 5 nanoseconds of delay. And again, there's a buffer, which is again having 5 nanoseconds of delay. And we have to execute 1000 data items on this pipeline, correct? Now you can see when we have buffers like this, if they are giving buffers, then every stage includes a total of buffer delay time as well as the stage time. So it is in the first stage we are going to have a delay of 155 nanosecond, which is 150 nanosecond plus 5 nanosecond. In the second stage we are going to have a delay of 125 nanoseconds. In the third stage we are going to have a delay of 165 nanosecond. And the fourth stage, we are going to have a delay of 145 nanoseconds. Now you understand that when we use pipeline, the first instruction that is going to be executed, it is going to utilize the entire time. But all the other instructions, they are going to come in after every cycle, and the cycle will be decided according to the maximum delay here. And the maximum delay is 165 nanoseconds. Okay, for this particular case, you can assume the first instruction that will come out after 155 plus 125 plus 165 plus 145 nanoseconds. This is for the first instruction, plus all the other n minus 1 instructions, they will come out after 165 nanoseconds each, because there is a maximum delay here. So here we have to execute a total 1000 instructions. So here actually they should have mentioned instruction instead of data items. So we have to execute 1000 instructions. So for 1000 instruction, the value of n will be 1000. So this will be 999. So let us evaluate these values. Let us calculate these values, and accordingly we can find out this. Okay. So here they are giving 155 plus 145, that is equal to 300. And this is 125 plus 165. And that is approximately equal to 290, I guess. So it is 590 nanoseconds from here. And from here, okay, let me do one thing. Let me open a calculator first, and I'll show you by calculators after calculating. So here we have a total of, it's a calculator, yeah. So we have a total of 155 plus 125 plus 165 plus 145 nanoseconds, which is equal to 590 nanoseconds, that is correct. And all the 999 instructions, they are going to take 165 nanoseconds each. So it is 164835. So this is going to give us 164835 nanoseconds. Okay, so in total, how many nanoseconds are these? We're just going to add 590 onto this. So add 590, so that is going to give us 165 425. So 165, 425 nanoseconds to process all these 1000 instructions, right? But you can see the answers which are given, that is in microsecond, and we are getting the answer which is in nanosecond. So we have to convert these nanoseconds to microsecond. Okay, so how many nanoseconds are there in 1 microsecond? So in 1 microsecond there are 1000 nanoseconds. Okay, so here we have these many nanoseconds, so we have to identify how many microseconds will be there. So we are just going to divide this number by 1000. So we are going to get 165425 divided by 1000 microsecond, which is approximately equal to 165.5 microsecond. So the answer for this question is option number C. Actually, this is the closest one, because here the answer should be 165.42 microsecond, but again we are getting 165.5 microsecond, which is the closest answer. So answer for this question is option number C. Correct. Now let us look at the next question.